Hello! Today we're going to talk about master pages and how to give your thesis a good structure. This means that we're going to create a font page, we're going to add page numbers, and we also create a running header for each page. If you want to follow along with the tutorial, you find the document we're using today again on my website. I also included some pictures that we're going to use this time. If you're ready, open your document and we can get started. To give your thesis a good structure, you should insert some page breaks. You can do this by clicking in your text, right-click, insert break character, and then on page break. Now you get a little blue symbol over here that indicates that the page is broken at this point. So the text will continue on the next page. We insert some more page breaks between the abstract and the table of contents. Now we need to delete this line breaks over here. And also again between the introduction and the abstract. I have already inserted the other page breaks for you, so we can go to our next point, which is numbering. Not all pages in our thesis will have the same kind of numbering. Our front page that we see here will have no numbering at all. Our table of contents will have Roman numbering. And our other pages in the thesis, indicated by orange here, will have normal numbering. Now we need to tell this in InDesign. Therefore, we're going to table of contents and go on right click in numbering options. And we say start a new section. Also, this is now at page 2, it's number 2, but because it's the second page in our document, but you want to start numbering at 1. And we select the Roman number style. Now we get an OK, and we see we get this little arrow here that tells us here is starting a new section. Now we also need to start a new section for the rest of our text. But we want normal numbers like 1, 2, 3, but they are already occupied by our front page now, so we need to change this. We say we want the style, for example, ABC. Now we can select the style decimal numbers. And also we should start numbering at page 1 again. As we are happy with our numbers, it's time to get the numbers on the pages. For this, we should use master pages. You find master pages in the top panel of your pages window. And I have opened here the master page A. I placed a picture here to show you what is the effect. All the orange pages have the master A applied. You can see this as a small A symbol on each page. So the master page A is used as kind of a background that is overlaid on each page. If we delete this and insert a small text box over here, where we place our page numbering, we get a page number on every orange page. To insert the current page number, select the type tool and go on right click, insert special character markers, and count page number. You should make sure that the paragraph style is basic text. Now we will get the page number on every page that has the master A applied. For example, page 6, we see a 6 down here, and the same for the other pages. As we can see, this page with the table of contents doesn't have a master applied because it doesn't have the letter A over here. So to apply a master to this page as well, you just select this master over here and drag it on the page. Now we get the Roman number for 1 down here. Our title page shouldn't have a number at all, so we just keep master none. Now it's time to take care of our front page. One important thing is to dissolve the link between the text boxes here to avoid overflowing text. Therefore, we need to delete this box, but we're going to copy the text in there first. Then we delete it, we get a little warning, but we can ignore that. And we're going to create a new text frame and paste in our text again. I'm going to speed this up a little bit. Basically, you just play around now and increase the text size and make it look good and also insert some pictures. So, see you back in a second. This could be one example how your thesis could look like. I'm also going to show you now another way to do it. If your university has a fancy logo, you can take it and put it in the background. Just scale it a little bit, rotate it, change the opacity to 50%. Then you can arrange it, center back, to have it behind the text, and then position it on the page where you want to have it. I hope my two examples did give you some inspiration, and feel free to create your own cover page in your style, but also get some feedback from your parents or friends to make sure that it's a nice cover page. The final thing we're going to talk about in this video are running headers. To create a running header, we first want to create a line that is going above our text. To create a line, we should make sure that we have under grids and guides, smart guides activated that will help us to draw the line. If you press the shift key, you can make sure that you draw a straight line. Now the line has the same dimensions as text. We can copy this one and take it with us to our master page. We position it above the text, make it a little bit thinner, like 0.5. And now we can create a text frame above this line. This one will hold our running header. We want to change the paragraph style to font to get rid of this indent here. And now we need to create our variable for the running header. To do this, we go on type, text variables, define. We can go on new and we call our variable running header. The type is a character style running header. We need to create this style. We say new character style and we call it again running header style. There will be no style options in this style, we just keep it as it is. Go on OK. Then we use first on page. And we can go on OK. That's pretty much it. Now we can insert this variable with insert variable running header. We don't see anything here because we now need to see, if we go to our pages, that we include our headlines in this. And this is done by editing the headlines. Go on edit. And now we go on drop caps and nested styles, and we create a nested style. We say it should have the style running header through, let's say, 3 sentences. And we go on OK. This will apply our character style to this headline. If we now refresh the page, we have the introduction over here. Let me explain quickly how this works. The introduction headline has the style we created assigned, and the program looks for the first headline that has this style. The other headlines don't have this character style at the moment. If we go on the next page, we get therefore introduction as the running header and not this headline, for example. Therefore, if we want to include these headlines into the system, we need to go on paragraph styles, also for head 2, go on edit, and do the same thing again. You say new style over here, running header 3, and you say this should be a sentence. So through the first 3 sentences. Go on OK. And now if we go down here, we have headline or something from here as our header. Because on this page there are no other headers, so it looks on the page before which header was present here. Now we have the problem, if we look at the whole page, we don't have much space on top here. We should move this all stuff a little bit down to get more space over here to have it look nice. We could do it by hand, but there's a nice trick to make it a little bit easier for us. We can go to the master page and we go on layout, layout adjustment, and make sure that we have layout adjustment enabled. Then we can go on margins and columns and we can change the top margin. This is the box we have here and we pull it down like let's say 10 millimeters more. So we type in 30 millimeters and go on OK. And now it's moving down a little bit. We also put the running header down like this. And we can see on our pages what the result is. As you can see, on all pages that have the master A applied, the text was moved down a little bit. So now it looks really nice and how we want to have it. We can do some adjustments to the running header itself. We can move it down again some bits, but we also can write down our name if we want to. Let's say, for example, the date as well, when the thesis was written. And then we can, if we just select this, push this to the right. It also applies a character style for references. Let's see again how it looks on our pages. Yep, not so bad. I'm quite happy with this now. And again, also this one is working. As you can see here, by the way, we might need to do some adjustment again if we change the size of our text box. We can get something like this, so we would need to push this down a little bit so we have it on the next page, that it looks nice. Alright, this is pretty much everything I wanted to tell you today. See you guys next time. Bye.